Good morning, everyone. It's Kay called up, and welcome to a Stampin' Up! Video here. This is a Facebook Live, and you are at Stamping to Share, and I am so happy to be here. Thank you so much. I'm going to quick look at the comments. Oh, good. I have my regulars with me. Thank you so much for joining me. I love seeing Christine and Connie. It's great to have you here. Deb is here. Thank you. Nancy is joining us. Yeah, so we have a few people already tuning in. That's so much fun. It just makes my heart feel so happy. And I also, it's going to sound kind of weird, but you know, please don't go back and look at my past Facebook Lives to check this out. But I have had an issue with my teeth lately, and I thought I would share and how much it's been bugging me. It seems like whenever I'm getting ready for a Facebook Live, you know, let me preface this. I actually used to be a Mary Kay consultant. I was a Mary Kay consultant for 26 years, and I had used their products faithfully, but within the last year or so, I noticed that my teeth seemed to love the lipstick more than my lips. And it didn't even seem, no matter how I put it on, if I put it on with a foundation powder, the primer, whatever, I seemed like I was wearing the lip color on my teeth, which was really bugging me when I would go back and look at my Facebook Lives, especially when I would, you know, expand the screen and I'd see it on my great big computer and I'd be like, oh my gosh. Have you guys ever had that happen where you think you look kind of good and then you get the close-up and you realize, nope, that was not the case. So I started chatting with my daughters about this. And my daughter, who recently got married, Kari, was telling me that she really likes ColourPop lipsticks. And so I went to their website. Apparently, it's just an online place. I couldn't believe how inexpensive the lipsticks were. They were like $5 for a lipstick and then $5 for what they call like a lippy pencil to outline your lips in. So I bought some, and so far I think they're working really well. I'm really excited about them. And I know this is neither here nor there when it comes to Stampin' Up, but I just thought I'd share in case some of you have that problem. And I did talk to my dentist about it, and he said it's just because my enamel is kind of like wearing off on my teeth. I guess that's what happens when you're getting older, and maybe I didn't take such good care of my teeth in the past. I don't know. But so it makes it sort of like a good spot for the lipstick to gather. And so anyway, I have new lipstick now and I'm just so happy. It's just so funny how the little things can make such a difference. So I feel a little more confident. And then I've decided to share with you, oh goodness, we are going to be sharing so much today. Not only the card that I was planning on sharing with you Monday, which we had to move to Friday because I couldn't find the stamp set. Turns out I had borrowed the stamp set out to someone, and then my extra stamp set, well, let's just say I never did find the extra stamp set. I know it's in the house somewhere, but I don't know where. But the stamp set that I borrowed out, I did get back, and so I can now make this card for you. Hallelujah. And then I'm going to be sharing with you the bag we had at Spring Fling, or not Spring Fling, Fall Flare, the bag we had for all of our projects as well as our product bag. So we do a little product giveaway to everyone who comes, which usually has about $10 worth of products in it. And so I try to coordinate those bags so they look kind of cute together. So I'll show you that. And I'm also going to show you a promotion that started on November 1st, which is our Snowflake Showcase promotion. And so I've got two cards that I'm going to be sharing next week on my blog, and I'm really excited about them because on my blog next week, there won't be a video or anything like that, but I will be sharing the step-by-step project sheet on how to make them. And so there'll be no Facebook Lives next week, but there will be two updates to my blog, and I typically do my updates on Tuesday and Friday, so you can look for them then. And I'll have that information for you with those cute little snowflake cards that I made. Well, one's a snowflake card and the other one is kind of an all occasion card. I put congratulations on it. So let me see what you're all saying. Hi, everybody. It's great to have you here. Thank you so much. I'm really behind, too, on posting cards I've gotten in the mail. I've gotten such pretty cards in the mail. Thank you so much. I always am so tickled when I do a little giveaway. And, you know, I send out my little thank you card, my little tiny gift. And I'm always so tickled when you send back a card to thank me for my thank you. So that's just so cute. And that's just so stamper, you know? That is just pure, that's just the way us stampers are. We just love cards so much. It's just so much fun to send them to people. I think it's almost as much fun to send them as it is to make them. Let's see, is there anything else I want to cover before I switch the camera down? Oh, yes, I do have some things I want to cover. I want to tell you that I'm doing a little giveaway today. So let me show you this card again. Let me make sure I'm getting it in the picture. Of course, when I'm looking at myself on the screen, I'm always about 30 seconds behind. So I have to hold it here and make sure it's actually in the picture. But as you can see, there's no embellishments on here. So how is that going to work for a giveaway? So what I'm going to do is give away something different. I'm going to send the card, of course, to my two winners, which I'll pick on Monday. But here is the ribbon that I'm going to send you. So I'm going to send each of you 2 yards of this lovely ribbon. It's called Mary Merlot and Copper Reversible Ribbon. And it's from our holiday catalog. And I think you'll like it. If you haven't already got it, I think you'll enjoy having that nice 2-yard sample of it. And so it kind of coordinates. Okay, not really. But like I said, I didn't have any embellishments that went on that card. So how in the world do you get into these drawings? Well, it's really easy. First of all, you have to be on my Facebook Live when I do them, or you have to be watching from my Facebook page after I've done it, but before I've done the drawing. So you can find my Facebook page by just going to Facebook. This is for all the people that are on YouTube, by the way. I have to tell them how to get to my Facebook page. Actually, if you click the little more button, the little down arrow when you're in YouTube, you can see a link directly to my Facebook page. Anyway, if you get there before Monday, you can make a comment, tell me where you're watching from. I love hearing where you're all from. And sharing the video on your timeline, that's also much appreciated. And then I just do a little WooBox drawing on Monday, and I go ahead and notify my winners, and then I put the cards and the ribbon in the mail. And so that's kind of fun. But you do have to notify me with your address within 48 hours, because after that, I will not send the card to you. I just can't. I have too many downline members and too many customers placing orders with me that want to get cards from me. And so I can't just keep a card on my desk forever waiting for someone to contact me. So I give you 48 hours and then I just go ahead and send the card to somebody else. I hope you don't mind, and I'm sure you understand. So anyway, thank you everyone for being here. And I've also decided not to edit my video so much. I've decided to just go ahead and put these things onto YouTube and share more about my Facebook page, because I do a lot there and I'm planning to do a lot more. What else was I gonna say? Oh, and it'll save me so much time too, because editing takes a long, long time. Or at least it does for me. I don't know. Other people might be more skilled at it. So anyway, we're gonna go ahead and I'm gonna flip the camera down, and I've just got, like I said, so much to show you. We're gonna make 2 cards because they're so simple. I'm just gonna make them both at the same time, and we'll get started. All right, I think we've got a nice image here. So again, this is the card we're going to make, but I'm gonna put that aside for right now because I wanna show you the November special. This is the November special. And it is 2 stamp sets. One is called Happiness Surrounds. This is an all occasion stamp set. You can see there's congratulations, it's your day, hello friends, surround yourself with happiness. I mean, just kind of a lot of nice sentiments that work for, you know, pretty much all occasion cards. And then this also coordinates with it because you can see there is a little flower set that goes, you know, with some of the coordinating products in here, which is really nice. But this little set of thinlets, not only does it coordinate with this stamp set, Happiness Surrounds, but it really coordinates with the Snow is Glistening stamp set. I was amazed at all of the amazing things you can do with this. And I know I might as well just answer this because some of you are going to say, what in the world are you using here? What is this, Kay? Tell me now. Okay, so this is how many dies there are. I actually haven't even counted them, but there's a lot. And the thing with this is it just completely filled up my magnet card that I get from Stampin' Storage. I mean, I barely have any room on it at all. This is all of the dies on this magnet card. And then I was a little worried because there's so many little ones and I was afraid of them falling off and possibly losing them. And some of these dies do look similar to some other dies that I already had. So I want to make sure that I kept it all together. So I just took the little cellophane sleeve that this came in because it's one of those bigger die sets. And I discovered, much to my happy surprise, that this little cellophane sleeve from Stampin' Up! That comes with your die sets actually fits that Stampin' Storage magnet card perfectly. So it's really, really nice to just store this in then with all your dies and you don't have to worry about anything getting caught and slipping down. So that's what this is, because I just know you're going to ask me. So that's what I did here. So this is, like I said, the Snow is Glistening, and there's a huge amount of stamps in here, and they're big. So they're a lot bigger than what it shows on the actual outside of the stamp set, so just be aware of that. So you can make some really nice, good images. And are you ready to see the cards that I did? Let me show them to you. So these are the cards that will go up on my blog next week. This will be the one that goes up on... I'm going to put that up on Tuesday. Yes, I'm going to put this up on Tuesday. And then I'm also going to share with you, when I put it up on Tuesday, this Snow is Glistening project sheet. So it gives you the step-by-step instructions and then all the products that I used with it. So I'll have that in a PDF format for you to download. And isn't it gorgeous? It uses the black foil paper that we have in the Holiday 2018 catalog, which I love that paper. I mean, at first when I saw it, I thought, oh, well, this is kind of Halloween-y. But then I thought, you know what? It's also like a beautiful starry night as well. So then what I did is I put all these snowflakes up here. And then this is our white velvet textured paper, which really has a nice feeling to it. And so that's the next layer, which is also part of the Snowflake Showcase. And then I used the champagne. Then I have a little outline stamp here to mat this champagne foil. And then this is one of those epoxy droplets that you can also find in the catalog. So I hope you love this card as much as I do. It also includes one of these cute little guys down here, which is one of the little snowflake elements that you can also purchase as part of this wonderful product that's only available in November. So do remember that. You have to get it before November 30th because it's a limited edition set. So there we go. So those two just coordinate really well together. And then let me show you the second card. This is the one I'll put up on Thursday on my blog at stampingtoshare.com. And I will have the project sheet there for you on Thursday, which is going to look like this. This one doesn't have the directions, but I do have directions for it. I just didn't get that one all quite done yet. But trust me, it will be done by Thursday. So this is the card, and I think it turned out so nice. When my daughters saw it, they loved it. That was their favorite card that I had made because they love the colors. They just thought it was so pretty for a congratulations card. And one thing I did too to just kind of up my game with this is I used the shimmery white paper, which is lovely, absolutely lovely. If you don't have the shimmery white paper, it is a little more expensive than like purchasing Whisper White or something like that, but it is so worth it because as you move it in the light, it shimmers and it's just gorgeous. And isn't this fun down here? You can make little borders with one of the stamps in the stamp set. So it's these little borders right here. And I just stamped them across the bottom. And because it's a photopolymer stamp set, it just, it's just so easy to line up. And I love that about it. So that is that card. And then this is one of those really cool faceted gems that's in our regular annual catalog. And this is the clear one. They also come in gold. But I took the biggest one because it really looked pretty with this flower. Don't you think? I just love, love, love it. And then, of course, this is with the dies. So this is, so a lot of, these are all in colors. I just realized that. This is the Berry Burst. We've got Call Me Clover. And then Pineapple Punch. So those are the three in colors that I use. And of course, I use these two thinlets right here that kind of coordinate so that I could get this cute little punch out flower for this congratulations card. So let me move on now to some things that we did at Fall Flair. So those of you that are local and have attended my Fall Flair, you know that we get a project bag with all of the things that we're going to do during the day. And so I have my niece actually make these up. So we usually have, you know, anywhere from 100 to 120 attendees. And so I pay her $1 a bag. So she, I cut the paper for her, but she does the assembling for me. So we use one of these wire elements and we use this really pretty trim right here, and then we've got the All is Bright Designer Series paper. So what I did is I just took a sheet of the All is Bright Designer Series paper and I cut it in half, and then I cut it in half again so that I had 4 6-inch squares. Then I took my 6-inch square and I cut 2 inches off the bottom of it and I flipped it over. I used the triple banner punch? Is that what I used? Yes. And it cuts 1 inch, 1.5 inch, and 2 inches. Whoops, I'm sorry about that. So yes, then I just trimmed off the bottom with the triple banner punch and we just stapled this all on and it was so pretty. So we used all the different styles of paper that were available in that paper pack and I think it just turned out so nice. So my niece Molly made up all of these for me and she does such a fantastic job. I just love it. All right, so let us move along. Then I'll show you the product. Well, I should leave this in the picture for a second because I should show you the product gift that coordinates with it. So we went again to the All is Bright Designer Series paper. And again, we used the triple banner punch because we have a 2-inch strip here and a 1.5-inch strip here. And this triple banner punch just makes it so fast for making banners. I love it. Then we have the curly, no, not the curly, it's the pretty label punch. And this is for you, is just a little stamp from the treat, it's a treat bundle that you can find in the holiday catalog. And again, we designed it so that we could use one of these pretty wire embellishments. So thank you all for your compliments on the bags. I truly appreciate it. We love doing these. And I should mention that one of my downline, Michelle, created this for us. And I think I should show you the name tag too, but I don't have one handy here, but we have some really cute name tags that my assistant Kim did for us. I'll have to show that to you the next time I do a Facebook Live. All right, so let's go ahead and get started with this pretty card. This is a Thanksgiving card. Now, I don't know about you, but I do send Thanksgiving cards because I have, I just can't get to everybody on Thanksgiving. My relatives and all live too far apart. So this is the card I'll be sending them. And what I did is I have some 5.5 by 8.5 early espresso paper that I've scored at 4.25. I'm just going to go ahead and make sure that this lies flat for us. And then I have a second one here because we're making two cards. These are so quick and easy. I just thought, you know what, we'll just go ahead and make two right off the bat. And this is the spotlight technique. So I'm going to show you just how easy it is to do this. I mean, so easy. It's just fun to do because it's easy to do. And I love fun and easy. And I think you do too. I see lots of lots of thumbs up there. Thank you. All right, so the first thing we're going to do is we're going to just go ahead. There's no ribbon wraps or anything like that, so we're just going to get some things out of the way on my desk. I have some, this is pumpkin pie paper. Are you guys noticing my finger? Like, this one's bright red and this one's half and half. That's because for some reason my index finger on my right hand is a little bit cold. So I've got this really cool nail polish on that is sort of a mood polish. So as my fingertips get colder, the mood polish kind of changes, which is kind of weird. It's looking kind of weird, but that's what's going on in case you're wondering. So we're going to just take some multi-purpose liquid glue. And we're going to glue these down onto the fronts of our card. So pretty easy. A lot of the cards at Spring Fling and Fall Flare, something that we do twice a year, a lot of them are pretty easy, lots of layers, because we have everybody there. These are brand new stampers to really experienced stampers. And I'll tell you what, experienced stampers like easy cards too. Or not really easy, but easy and elegant is kind of what I like to say. So 4 by 5 1/4 is, again, what we're gluing onto these card fronts. And again, that's pumpkin pie, and the card base is early espresso. So there we go. Fun and done. Now the next thing we're going to do is we're going to do our punch outs. So we need two pieces of, well, you could just use one piece. I'm grabbing it out of my box over here. I have two pieces of scrap. This is So Saffron, and I'm just gonna grab a little scrap piece here. And I'm going to ink up the pheasants with early espresso ink. Just like so. And we are just going to stamp this right here. And I'm not getting, I'm really after the heads. So I'm just kind of making sure that my punch will reach in and take that out. So I'm going to do the same thing over here and give that a press, and ta-da. All right, now we're going to do the spotlighting part. So all you need to do that is your 2-inch circle punch. So we're just gonna go in and we're just kind of figuring out where those heads are so we can see both the hen and the drake. And there we go. So we've got one punch out, and then we're going to do the second punch out. And that's all there is to it. So we have that part done. Then I've got a piece of scrap paper here. This is, again, early espresso. And I'm going to take my Starburst punch, and we're just gonna make two punch outs from this piece of scrap. And there it is. So that was easy. That's what we're gonna put our circles onto. And I think we're just gonna go ahead and we'll just put a little glue on here and set this on here. And I better put it on my white paper so you can see what the heck I'm doing. So look how perfectly that fits. Isn't that gorgeous? And it doesn't, like, this is just like the perfect size for a spotlight technique, because you don't want to have a too big of a border, because if you have too big of a border, then it cuts out too much of your main image. So this just is perfect. I love it. And so let me go ahead and do this one. Now, I've heard some people say they weren't real keen on Pleasant Pheasants because, you know, they just weren't keen on it. They thought it was too much coloring. Well, as you can see, I did not do any coloring, and I think it's absolutely lovely. So you don't have to color it if you don't want to. But if you do want to, you can use your Stampin' Blends, which one of my customers from the Hayward area did, and it turned out beautiful. She sent me a picture of it. So it was gorgeous. Just Stampin' Blends, and it was beautiful. I would imagine she probably looked up on the internet what colors a pheasant was, because it looked pretty realistic to me. All right, what's the next thing we can do? I know. Let me grab. Uh-oh, where'd it go? Here it is. So here is some very vanilla paper. So we're going to do our banner. So this card has a banner that says Happy Thanksgiving, and it's 1 by 4 inches. So let me take my triple banner punch, And we'll just go in here and we'll just instantly turn it into a banner. I love that. And then I have one that I've already pre-punched, so we'll go ahead and do our stamping. So again, it is Early Espresso ink, and we're just going to stamp this pretty much smack dab in the center. And we'll do that for both of these banners. And there it is. So we have our really pretty Thanksgiving banners. Now, to highlight the banners, we're going to add some leaf punch out. So I have my leaf punch, and we're going to need, because we're making two cards, we're going to need two pumpkin pie leaves, leaf punch outs, I should say. And then we're going to need two of our early espresso leaves. So we'll just punch those out. And there we go. That was easy. Then what I like to do is I am just going to, I'm going to do this a little different. I'm going to move this out of the way so we get it out of the way. And I think I should do a little more stamping. As long as I've got the ink out, let me go ahead and stamp the rest of this stuff. So we've got a panel of So Saffron. It's 3 3/4 by 5 inches. And I'm going to put that over the top of the paper, paper pumpkin, over the top of the pumpkin pie. So let me go ahead and get that ready. So we need, again, our pheasant stamp. And then we're just going to open up the early espresso ink pad here. And let me go ahead and try to evenly ink this. So I just hold it in my hand like this and just pat all around. And then we're going to set this on here. And the reason we want to make sure that our left side of our stamped image goes to the left side of the paper is we want to make sure that our spotlight technique will be fully onto this paper and not half hanging off. So therefore, when you do stamp it, you want to make sure that you have this far enough to the left that you have plenty of room for your spotlight. And that looks perfect. So we've got that one done. I'm getting a little wild here. Then we'll do the second one. And again, we're just going to set this in here about like so. And there it is. And we're going to do the inside panel too. Now you guys haven't even seen the inside panel, so this will be a bit of a surprise. But it's the exact same measurements as what my front panels were. So I'll just slip this paper on here. It was 3 3/4 by 5 inches. So thank you everyone so much for joining me, telling me where you're from. I love having you here. And so for the inside panel, I'm going to grab, there's a little border stamp, and why am I not seeing it on my table? Because it should be here, but I'm not seeing it. Well, I don't know what happened to it. So we're going to stamp the sentiment first. That's just going to go right here. Wishing you health, happiness, and the riches of God's bounty during this season and always. Perfect sentiment for Thanksgiving. And honestly, I don't see my, I don't know what I did with it. Did I not even use it? Let me find my stamp set. Nope, I took it out of the stamp set, but I don't know where it went. Well, you know what? Stuff like that happens. So I will show you what the card looks like, and then once I find it, I'll stamp it later. But there's this really pretty set of border leaves that come with the stamp set. And I'm going to stamp once at the top and once at the bottom. So when you get this card in the mail, if you're one of my winners, you will see that your inside looks like this. All right, so let's keep rolling along here. I'm really surprised I can't find that stamp set, but you know, my video here was going along pretty perfectly, so I suppose I had to have some little snafu to keep it real. Okay, so now we're going to take those two panels and we are going to work with those before we actually glue them down. So we've got the Thanksgiving pieces and I'm just going to put those on with a little bit of snail. So bear with me here. So I'm just going to add a little snail to the back of each one. And then we're going to set these in so it's about, maybe not quite a half inch from the bottom. So we want to leave some room for our leaves here at the top. So we'll do the same thing here. We'll set this in, and doesn't that look pretty? This one needs to come down just a hair, and that looks good. Then we can flip them over and burnish them so they stay in place. Then we're going to take our little leaves, and we're just going to add a couple of dots of glue to the back. Very, very little glue, because really, glue works. I mean, glue, once it's on there, it's really on there. And we're just going to set this in. I'm just going to pull this up a little bit and set this in so that the leaf goes a little bit over this vanilla panel. And I'll do the same thing with this one. So we'll just add a little bit of glue. And then we'll flip it over and we'll kind of bend that back and set it in just like this. Then we're going to do the same thing with the early espresso leaf. Add a little bit of glue here. And then we're going to set this in just like this. So right over the top. And then what I like to do is just keep that one leaf kind of over the top of that sentiment panel. Look at how pretty that is. So we'll do the same thing to this one. Glue is so handy, don't you agree? I know not everyone's a glue person. You can do it however you want, whatever works best for you. In fact, it's kind of fun to see from the comments, do any of you like the glue for stuff like this, or do you just prefer and use snail all the time? I think that's kind of interesting to find out. All right, now we're ready to go ahead and put these panels on. So let me go ahead and do that if I can get the glue out here. There we go. And we'll set this in. Well, good morning, everybody. Again, thank you for joining me. I see lots of my friends here. Thank you. All right, there it is. So now just like this is a very pretty card. So if you don't have those punches to do the spotlight technique, you could pretty much call yourself done at this point. And it's a nice flat card too, so you can mail it without worrying about embellishments or anything like that. So that is beautiful, just like that, isn't it? But we are going to add the spotlight in a second here. And then I'm just going to do a little bit of glue on the back of these inside panels. And we'll set those in. Again, I don't have my border stamp on the table. I wonder if it fell down. I don't see it on the floor. Who knows? But I'm sure I'll find it, because I remember putting it on a block. It just never made it to the table. So we'll set this one in here. Pretty, pretty, pretty. Okay, now let's go ahead and add our spotlight. So to do that, we need a little dimensionals here. Very pretty. And then, of course, for those of you that are on YouTube, if you want to hop on over to my Facebook page, if you do that before Monday, and I don't even know what day Monday is, November 5th, that's when I'll do the drawing, so you can make a comment there. Or if you're watching already on Facebook and you'd like to make a comment or share this video, thank you so much, go ahead and do that, and then you'll be in the drawing. And again, I am giving away some Mary Merlot ribbon. I usually give away an embellishment that's on the card. Well, this card didn't really have many embellishments. It's so easy. So I'm going to do 2 yards of Mary Merlot ribbon. So now what we do is we just take this spotlight panel and we just set it in so that it all lines up. And you give it a little press and there's one. And then we'll do the same thing over here. Just line it up so that the image lines up really nice. And there it is. Do you love it? If you do, be sure to give me a heart. Be sure to like this. It makes me feel so good to see that you liked this video. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel, please be sure to do that. That's wonderful of you to do that and show me how much you care.